And Lourdes, even as adults clamor for vaccines, they're not available to children. That's because clinical trials up until now did not include kids. And while they typically have fewer symptoms than adults with COVID-19, kids can spread the disease. Experts say they need protection to keep us all safe, but there is a pressing medical concern as well.
Vaccines were developed. They were tested on adults. 44,000 got the Pfizer shot, 30,000 received Moderna's.
Ready?
At warp speed, the vaccines were made available, and relief, joy spread. But many parents wondered, if studies show they're safe, why can't my child get the shot at beating a deadly disease?
One really needs to study children and can't just extrapolate that information about safety and effectiveness from the adult data. And that's the way that vaccine studies have pretty much always been done.
As with most vaccines and drugs, clinical trials begin in adults. Successful results then open the door for pediatric participation.
The expectation would be, hopefully, that 12 to 15-year-olds will be able to be vaccinated, perhaps even as soon as late this spring or this summer. And perhaps by the fall, children even as young as first grade and up will be able to be vaccinated.
Pfizer enrolled 2,259 12 to 15-year-olds so far. Moderna's goal is 3,000.
With each additional age group that's studied, it could be that it is a compressed trial period.
Most kids do not get seriously ill with COVID-19. 3 million were diagnosed in this country. 200 died. But there is also a risk for a secondary illness, a post-infection called multi-system inflammatory syndrome in children, or MIS-C.
There have been around 2,000 children to date that have presented with a very severe post-COVID illness. And most of these children have no recollection of ever having been sick with their COVID illness. The overwhelming percentage of these children have ended up in the intensive care unit receiving critical care. And many of them have had significant cardiac abnormalities.
In addition to their risk for secondary illness, there's another argument to vaccinate more kids. Doctors say herd immunity will positively impact people of every age.
Since the children are at such high risk, even if asymptomatic, to spread it to the adult population, I just think that it's really important to think about that when you know that there have been 3 million positive kids already.
So maybe fall for first graders to 17, 16 years old. The next phase is babies. UIC, which participated in the adult Moderna trial, is hoping to study the vaccine in infants up to 12-year-olds. May take a little longer, but with each time that there is an approval for a certain age group, speeds up the time for the next age group.
That makes sense.
Got it. But I would imagine it might be difficult to get people to enroll in a trial when you're dealing especially with the youngest kids.
Surprisingly, Pfizer's the 12 to 15-year-olds. Filled up like that within a week.
Good to know.
Okay.